Hi everyone and welcome back to a new video. And you might notice by the sound quality and the video quality and also the background furniture that I'm not at home. I'm on vacation. I'm 1 week on the beautiful island of Mallorca. I've never been here. I know I'm a German and I've never been to Mallorca. This is the reason why I had to change that, because I think it's like basically national German culture to visit Mallorca once in your life. If you're from farther away, there's like the rumor that, or like not the rumor, but the joke that Mallorca is also part of Germany because Germans love to make vacation here. And I see the reason why. I'm not in like the super touristic area. I'm more in the northeast. It's also very touristic, but it's not like the party tourism stuff. And yeah, I have some time to relax here. Food is prepared for me. I'm just lying on the beach. And of course, I use this time to play my favorite video games and work on my pile of shame, more or less. This is why I thought I will show you what I packed for this trip in the sense of gaming equipment. And yeah, so please apologize that like the video quality and the audio quality is not the best, but I thought you would prefer a not so professional video over a non-video at all. Okay, let's come to the first part, the obvious one. My Switch Lite, of course I had to pack it. I'm still in love with this thing. It's so beautiful, it's so light, and it's perfect for a vacation. I finished Link's Awakening before I went on vacation, so I did not bring that game with me, but loads of other games. At the moment, I'm obsessed with Untitled Goose Game. This game is just hilarious. I really, really love it. I got it on sale on the eShop. And yeah, a lot of other games that are here in my gaming case, the official one. I also have a USB-C loading cable in here at all times. And these are the games I brought with me. I think I showed them to you up close. So at first we have Toad's Treasure Tracker here, a really cute game that I want to finish. I've been working on that for quite a time, but not like in one rush or one sitting, just a few levels here and there. I mean, it's quite short, so I might be able to finish it, but I also want to 100% it and get like all the secret challenges, and that's like the more difficult part. Then Dragon Quest Builders, the same for that. Like, these were my two main games, I think, for September that I was playing. I'm planning on doing another video about like my gaming diary in September, but yeah, this is like more of my side scroller, or like, it's not 2D, but it's a 3D platformer game, and this is one of my bigger games, RPG like games. It's not a real RPG, I think. It's Dragon Quest Builders, more like a Minecraft Dragon Builders crossover, but like one of the bigger games. I think I have 60 hours on that, and I'm in chapter 3, so yeah, still a lot to do. Then we have Donkey Kong's Tropical Freeze, another 2D side-scroller, one of the best, I think people say, and it's perfect for a vacation. I mean, it's on a tropical island, so yeah, that's why I had to bring this one, but actually, I don't think I will have time to play this one. Pokemon Let's Go Eevee. I'm really in the mood for Pokemon at the moment on the Switch Lite. And I also transferred my save data on the Switch Lite because you don't have cloud saves for Pokemon. And that's why I brought it with me. Yeah, I'm really in the mood to try it out a little again. Then I have Rayman Legends. I really like this game, especially the multiplayer. So much fun. And yeah, another 2D side-scroller for me. I love my 2D side-scrollers. They are one of my favorite genres. But usually I just play one at a time. So why did I bring three? Yeah, maybe this was a little wasteful. Then we have Mario and Rabbids Kingdom Battle. I got this DLC for this recently in a sale, so I'm curious about playing that. And Hyrule Warriors. I'm playing Diablo with my friends at the moment online, and I'm really getting into the hack and slay thing a little, like to get off some aggression. So I was thinking about maybe starting this finally, because I'm also in the Zelda mood because of Link's Awakening. Then we have here Civilization 6, an awesome, awesome game for in between. I do some turns and here and there. And this is like a game you can play for like just 5 minutes. Of course, not a whole round, but it's like you start a game and it takes forever and ages, and you can do some turns in between, but you can also get lost in it for hours and hours and hours. So I always have it with me. And Puyo Puyo Tetris, because I was liking Tetris 99 at the moment, but before I get Tetris 99, the full version, before I buy that, I thought maybe you could play a little bit more,
a little bit more of this because I have it lying around and I almost never played it. And the last one we have in the Switch Lite case is also a quite new one, the Harry Potter one, Harry Potter, Lego Harry Potter collection, the full collection. And yeah, it's quite new and I always wanted to have it, so I was thinking maybe I'm wanting to start like the second half of it, but I don't think I will start it, to be honest. It's like, this is the thing for me. I want to be prepared for all the moods that I would be in, and I hate when I want to play a game and it's the one game I did not bring with me. I mean, that's like the disadvantage with physical copies, but I still love my physical copies. I want to collect them all. And yeah, but I usually carry more than I would need. Yeah. So yeah, lots to play already, but I'm kind of obsessed. This is why I still brought my big Switch. You saw it in the teaser for this video, or like in the intro. Why did I do this, Anna? Why didn't you bring like only one Switch? The thing is, I wanted to take my big Switch with me because I also have the dock with me here, and the AC adapter and HDMI cable. And this is what I love about the Switch, that you can just throw the dock in and two cables, and yeah, you have a console on the go, because like the Switch I can just put into my handbag or my backpack, and I just have to pack this dock. Would I do this with a PlayStation 4 or Xbox? Never. Or a PC. And this is what I love about it, not just the portability as a handheld, but also the portability as a whole gaming system if I want to play on a TV. And as I'm on vacation with a friend from a university of mine, we love to play Just Dance, and so for some Just Dance lessons, sessions, on the hotel room, I brought the dock with me, but also for maybe some Mario Kart or other games. Yeah, I mean, I don't think that I will have a lot of time to play on my own in the room, so it's basically for Just Dance and like movement games, but nevertheless, I brought some additional games here. Like in this case, this is like the big case for me. I have some games in here, and there are the Joy-Con straps, two of them at least, and a little cloth to clean the screen, because it gets very dirty with a lot of fingerprints. You have to use sunscreen, and sunscreen is really, really oily, as you can see on my face. It's not the natural glow, it's just sunscreen, because I don't want to turn into a tomato. yeah, and I'll show you the games I put in here. Those are mostly games that are not that fun to play on the Switch Lite, that are better on the big one. Yeah. For the OG Switch, and ooh, you can really see how the case is much more dirty compared to the Switch Lite one, I have Diablo 3, because maybe I would be in the mood for an online match with my friends on the weekend. They have the days off now as well, so why not? I always carry this around with me. Super Smash Bros. This was basically maybe for meeting people here in the hotel that are interested in Nintendo games, and then we can play some Smash Bros. Because people know Smash Bros. And they like Smash Bros. I don't like it that much, but just because I'm a total noob. I'm just so bad, and I don't want to put the time in that I would need to have to put in to get kind of good. Like not good, but in the way good that I could really play it with people and not suck the way that I am like last place all the time. So yeah, this was maybe, yeah, I always carry it around. I always carry this around just for the sake of people maybe wanting to try out the Switch, and Smash Bros. Is a game that most people know. Splatoon, of course, I'm not going anywhere without my Splatoon, but it's in this case because you also have no cloud saves for this, and my over 500 hour save file is on this Switch, so I'm not playing this with the Switch Lite, of course, and I'm not transferring it either. I want to play it on a TV. Then Just Dance 2019, and no, I think 2020 is coming out very, very soon, but I think it's still November. It's not coming out in October, or like the end of October, but I will usually wait until they are reduced, and then I get this one. But I have Just Dance Unlimited on this one, so I can use all the games, or play all the different online versions of the songs that they offer with the Ultimate version. And we have Super Mario Party, also same reason, maybe I was in the mood to play some Mario Party with my friend or with like people you meet here in the hotel. And the same for Mario Kart, because it's just a social game and most people know it, so I usually also, if I show off the Switch and people want to see what the Switch can do, you play around of Mario Kart with them, because everyone knows Mario Kart, and this is why I always have like Mario Kart and Smash with me, even though they're not my favorite games. And the reason for that is just that I'm bad at them. I'm just too bad at them to really enjoy them.
And you control them on the go. I brought my Pro Controller, of course. Never going anywhere with my Switch without this, like if I bring the dog and everything, because I just love it. I have a little Splatoon sticker on here. Unfortunately, it's fading away, but it's, in my heart, it's still there and I like it. And I have two additional Joy-Cons here. Why did I bring these? Maybe I could have left them at home, because for Just Dance you just need one. But maybe play some arms, and I think it's nicer if both of us have like two Joy-Cons, one, like two for each of the persons. And yeah, the straps for those, and this is like in this little bag here. But of course, you know, I love my Nintendo DS, and I'm a handheld obsessed girl, and therefore I had to bring one. I decided to bring the new 2DS XL because it's protected anyways with this little Pikachu case. I love it so much, it's so cute. And usually I just throw this into my handbag, so there's no case around it. This is a special case for the new... new Nintendo 2DS XL, those names are ridiculous. And I usually stored it in this one, but then decided that it's too bulky, too heavy, too big for the sake of just getting away with this all the time and taking it with me all the time. But like for the vacation, as it is also a good storage for games, I brought it for me. The same as with the Switches, I have the charging cable in here. This is like a USB charging cable, so I don't need the big one with the AC adapter on it. And there are some games here, and it's a mix of 2DS and not 2DS DS games and 3DS games. And I also have another little pouch here, which also holds four additional games, because this one is usually in my handbag, because when I don't bring this, I don't have all those games. I just prefer to have it without a case, and I also prefer just to have like four games with me, three to four games, because if I lose it or my handbag gets stolen, it's not my whole game collection that's gone. So this is why I love this system with just having three or four games with me at all the time, and like one in the system itself. And yeah, so all the other games can rest at home and are not in the, yeah, they are not endangered to be stolen or lost, because I'm a clumsy person, I lose stuff a lot. So let's have a closer look at those games as well. Okay, let's start with the little silver one. I have Super Mario Bros. 2. I love this game. I just love the new Super Mario Bros. Side scrollers. I love Mario side scrollers. They are just the classic games for me, like the classic side scrollers. It's everything else. It's just a rip off. Like Mario is for the OG for me, so I always carry them around with me. And I'm at my second playthrough of this, and yeah, I think I'm in World 6 or something like this. I cannot play those for hours and hours and hours. I usually play them or try one level for 50 minutes, 30 minutes, maybe 1 hour, and play some levels. And if it's not working, then I just turn it off and try again the next time. But I usually always have this with me. Xenoblade Chronicles 3D. Yeah, you know, I talked about this in the last one. I haven't started yet. I still don't know whether I want to start it now that the Switch version is announced. I still brought it here. Maybe if the mood would have struck me, I would have started it, but I don't think I will do this. And Kirby's Epic Yarn, because I'm also working on this one. I think I'm halfway through with it, and I have been playing a lot of this in, I think, August. So yeah, maybe I wanted to pick up this one again, so I packed it. And a few additional ones. I'm in a definite Zelda mood at the moment, so I have Phantom Hourglass with me because I want to finish it, but actually I think I have to start again or start over because I'm in the middle of it and I played it 3 or 4 years ago and I cannot remember it. And in the Nintendo DS I have Link Between Worlds, because I also have like 3 dungeons left on that and I just want to finish it. And after Link's Awakening it's like a natural progression to maybe do this one. I'm also so in love with WarioWare. WarioWare is just amazing, so I brought Touched with me, and I'm still waiting for DIY. I ordered it and it should be in, yeah, it should be waiting at home when I get home, it should be in the mail. Then new Super Mario Bros. The OG1, not the second one. You know, the same reasons as said before. Yoshi Touch and Go, because it's quite new and it's also supposed to be a really short game and a small game for in between, and it's supposed to be really cute on the DS, so I brought it to try it out. One Pokemon game, again, Pokemon X, same here. I'm 30 or 40 hours in and I don't know what I was doing. I think it got grindy now. I have to level my Pokemon to get like the next badge, and yeah.
I still brought it because I eventually want to finish it someday. Then I packed Luigi's Mansion, because Luigi Mansion 3 is like coming out very, very soon. So I thought maybe I start the series and maybe finish it before the third one comes out. Actually, I don't think I will make it. But in the case that I'm in the mood for it, I just brought it here. The same for Dragon Quest 4. I'm a little afraid of Dragon Quest XI. I really want to play it, but it's supposed to be such a long game. So I thought maybe I bring 4 because it's a shorter one and it's a good entry into the series, I heard. And yeah, it's quite new for me. So I brought this one. And as you saw with the tablet, or you will see, actually I'm filming this afterwards, after all. So, but don't tell anyone. I brought Art Academy because I'm into art a little at the moment and trying to get better drawing skills. And I thought maybe that's is a nice thing for in between, if you have like 5 minutes and nothing to do. So these are the DS games I brought. Now I think we're getting more into accessories. Of course I have a battery pack. This one has 2000 milliampere hours, but it's already like 2 to 3 years old. I got it around the time Pokemon Go started, so I think the capacity is going down a little. It's not the freshest, but it's still working fine, and I can charge my DS with it and the Switches when I'm lying on the beach. Yeah, I'm just, it's so amazing that I can play all those video games lying on the beach. I haven't done like an all-inclusive chill-out vacation. Like all my vacations over the last few years were like adventure vacations with looking at a lot of stuff and learning about culture, which is really, really nice, but it's more of a, not really a vacation, it's like an adventure, and I really wanted a holiday. I just wanted to relax for 1 week and just do all the stuff I love, whether it's gaming or reading or anything, and this is why I love this vacation so much at the moment. Half of it is over already, but I still have 3 more days to go, so fingers crossed that I maybe finish like one of those games. I guess Untitled Goose Game is the best candidate for that. You might ask yourself, Anna, why is your phone important for your gaming stuff? Because there's Wizards Unite on it and Pokemon Go. I'm still a big fan of augmented reality games, especially Wizards Unite. I know that it's kind of boring a little and a little more complicated than Pokemon Go, and there's a lot of stuff missing. They don't have raids yet and stuff like that. And to be honest, it's not a lot of stuff around here, so playing here is really hard, not a lot of inns or fortresses, so I won't get my daily bonuses, but it's fine. Yeah, but still quite important for me, and I love this game, and this is why this is also with me, and I wanted to show it to you. And of course for all the other stuff that you use your phone for. And I brought my kind of new tablet. It's the Galaxy Tab S6. I know Android tablets are dead. I still wanted one because I don't know, I don't like the restrictiveness of Apple products, to be honest. I have an iPhone that I use for work, and I see the benefits of it. It has its benefits, but I'm more of an Android girl, to be honest. But I mostly brought this because I'm getting into sketchnotes and sketching and art again. And this is the main reason why I got it and wanted to have a pen with it. To learn to draw a little, use it for work, but also for private stuff, also for university. As you know, I'm still doing my master's degree next to work, or like besides work. And yeah, I thought it's really, really, it's a really nice technique for notes taking and memorizing stuff more easily if you like combine it with little drawings and sketches. And that's what I'm working on at the moment, building my skills for sketch notes and also a sketch note library of symbols that I can use for myself. And this is why I brought this tablet. I mean, it's not gaming, but it's still a playful thing to do. So that's why I wanted to include this here. So yeah, that's it. My gaming travel bag, so to say. I hope you liked this video. I hope you thought it was interesting. Ooh, and there's a mosquito. The mosquito that is like torturing me all night long. Die, mosquito, die. No, stay here. I want to kill you. I know, don't kill animals. It's like a tiger one. It can spread diseases. We don't want diseases here. Okay, but now really, it's time to say goodbye. I hope you liked this video and see you again later. Bye. Thanks for watching.